It is 100 years old. It was started in 1912. And at that point in time in the history of Kentucky farming, there was a hog cholera epidemic. I mean, can you imagine that farmers across the state were losing money because they were losing their one of their cash crops, we'll call it. And therefore, the state government appropriated $12,000 to build a hog cholera chemistry lab, UK campus, which is where we're sitting now. So it, from that, obviously, anytime you have an epidemic, it ends at some point in history. And so it didn't last forever, and all of a sudden the ag school was actually looking at what do we do with the building now, which is this is no longer a priority. And so at that time in ag, they are having a, they're teaching students how to actually prepare cuts of meat. This means from lamb to hogs to beef, and they had actually, they had competitive teams, and they would actually go across the country actually competing to who could actually do the best rump roast or whatever they were doing. But after that, they actually started negotiating with the College of Medicine, because, you know, after the war they started thinking about a medical school here. So in the early 50s or mid 50s, when they were talking about building a current College of Medicine, they negotiated with the ag school for this particular building, so it became part of the University of Kentucky Medical Center. And at that point in time, it took on, it was an area for offices for dentistry, had some storage in here, I know that. And over the years, it became a machine shop. We taught CPR in here. And then in the late 80s, I was looking for a place to have the outreach center, so we took it over and renovated it. And since about 1990, it's been part of our program into the Outreach Center for Science and Healthcare Opportunity. And that's where we are now.
This building's been on the list to be demolished for what, like 25 years?
Oh, it's been on the demolition. This and the other maintenance buildings beside it has been on. In particular, when they were building the, I was really scared when they were building the Young Library, because the, I think the basic discussion was that some of these buildings leading up to it down Commonwealth, University Drive, was pretty distracting and ugly, I guess is the word that was used. Therefore, it would be better if we actually tore it down. But I don't think it's going to be torn down. I think the service it provides is sufficient to warrant its existence. Hopefully we'll get some more monies for renovation to keep it functioning, but so far so good.